Hi there, this is Alex with Pacific Northwest Bible Journaling and the Creative Retreat Design Team, and I'm here to go through Prayers of Boldness. This is my third or fourth entry, so you can see I've really been utilizing my devotional card, but today I'm going to focus on asking big questions and big prayers. And this word resistance on question number four made me think of these little succulents or cacti and how they're prickly, and it just gave me this visual of resistance. And so I decided for a couple of my entries, actually, I used the cactus to kind of represent that for me. So I decided to dive into Psalm 145, 18 through 19 here. And my goal was to use some of my stickers, which I hadn't, because the last entry I did was focused on printables. So I really went for it and pulled out that little cacti and then made the title at the top of my page say, "On My Knees." And you'll see me position and reposition stickers. I'm kind of like that. I don't always know at the beginning where I want everything placed. And then I went for a tab because I wanted to remember that this title of the entry was going to be big prayers, because when you face resistance, a lot of times that requires a really big prayer. And so I used the sticker big, and I was going to stamp prayers on it in a minute. I did choose to use the kind of seafoam green side facing towards the entry, but I love the little succulent purple that actually makes the back of the tab look lovely as well. Then I use those bold words, "God is bigger," because when you're facing resistance and praying big prayers, that's exactly what you need to keep in mind, is that God is bigger than your needs and he's bigger than anything that you could ask of him. I went back and forth on how to add a three-dimensional touch to this page. I decided to stamp that word prayers on the tab so that I knew spacing-wise what I had left. I don't always move in a linear way. My brain just doesn't work that way. And so a lot of times creating the space and the design before I journal, I do jump all over. I do know that I try to create kind of a triangulated effect with my designs. This one, you'll see I create kind of a top section, that middle section, and then later on using the stamps, I create something on the other side of the passage. That is not a typical strategy for me, but in the end, I love how it turned out. I also usually find some way to emphasize the scripture. This time I decided to just use black pen, which when I stamped the word prayers at the top, there left this little residual black dots of ink. And so then I decided to incorporate that on the edges of my outline. So you see, I added a bunch of little dots and later add some details even on the tab to make those little ink smudges look intentional. And in the end, I love little art marks like that, that fill your page and sometimes help you cover up a wee mistake. And then I decided that with the black outline around the scripture, I wanted to outline the title stickers as well. I don't end up outlining God is bigger and the succulent because I felt like once I journal around it, it will make those stickers pop enough. I did add a little bit of flare to the tab at the top. I like to make them kind of look like a cluster there. And then here I cut out the quote from question number five by Adam Clark. And I cut it out and then I'm mounting it using just some printer paper from this month's printables. If you haven't checked those out, they are awesome. CC designed some fabulous, really well-coordinated colors and printables for this month. This entry doesn't have any of them, but I have them printed and on hand. So I just use the white printer paper to back the quote. The quote itself says, "Ask with confidence and humility, seek with care and application, knock with earnestness and perseverance." And as I face resistance, I felt like those specific things, ways to ask, seek, and knock were important for me to keep in mind. So I actually wanted to incorporate that exact quote. So that's why I cut it out, almost like creating a little bit of word fetti yourself. It also tied the seafoam green of the tab at the top down to the bottom of my page. And anytime you mount something on white, it just gives it that little bit of extra pop. And then I used the Illustrated Faith highlighter washi, which is a favorite of mine, to give the edge of the quote a little bit of interest. It also brings the washi from the top of the page and ties it to the bottom. So you see, I'm looking for ways to link elements of my page so that the design really is cohesive. Then I pulled out the stamps. I really haven't gotten to use these Ask, Seek, Knock stamps. And so I decided this was a way to take the parts of the quote that I was really focusing on and emphasize them even further. I could see myself repeating those exact this exact quote in another entry where I use the words Ask, Seek, Knock stamps to repeat the quote because I just love it so much. So Ask, Seek, and Knock, and then I actually handwrite in the rest of the Clark quote below it. That really then helped me, you know, sometimes the repetition is what our heart just needs. And so I focused in on those elements that he was encouraging us with. Confidence and humility, seeking with care and application, knocking with earnestness and perseverance. And I just thought, as I meditated and wrote out, Lord, how could I be doing those things in my prayers and in my life? I date stamped the bottom, and then I was able to always clear my space. I try to do this right before I journal, so I kind of clear my head, look at the page as a blank slate, and then think, okay, what do I want to say to the Lord now that my design elements are done? So I wrote out my prayer, and I just said, Lord, I call on you, holding on to the truths in your word. Only you are bigger than our complete inadequacies and all our problems. I ask with humility and confidence for your power in my weakness. I seek with genuine care. When my compassion wanes, grow it in me. I knock earnestly with perseverance, knowing you are near to me when I call. Amen. And one of the things that I was really trying to encourage my spirit when I wrote this prayer was that opening line that, Lord, I call on you, holding on to the truths of your word. And I know that by being in God's word, reading it, hiding it in my heart, I'm hiding his truths there. And then I can pray those truths over myself, over my loved ones, over my friends and family. And so when I write a prayer, when I share a prayer, when I text a prayer to a friend, I really do try to include God's word, his truth, because that is something we can pray confidently. Here I just underline anytime the writing is my own thoughts, and that concludes my entry. I hope you enjoyed it and that you maybe got some inspiration for one of your own entries. This is Alex of Pacific Northwest Bible Journaling, joining you here on the Creative Retreat YouTube channel to talk through one of my entries from the Prayers of Boldness Faith Art Box kit for May. You can shop the kit and the supplies I used in this entry in the links below. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel so you don't miss a thing. Thanks for tuning in. Happy Bible journaling!